Our final award of the day is the Bernard Delfont Award for an outstanding contribution to show business. And this year's winner has most certainly achieved that. He started his acting career by bluffing his way onto the set of Coronation Street, playing Betty Turpin's illegitimate son, Gordon Clegg. He then turned his hand to producing and has just celebrated 30 years as a West End theatre impresario. With over 350 shows behind him, he's one of this country's most prolific theatrical producers.
Lucy, I'm trying to be serious.
All right then, be serious.
Well, I suppose that's part of it, isn't it? I mean, we're young, aren't we?
Oh, but we're very lovely.
And there won't be much money like that, not to start off with.
Oh, we'll live off love.
In my job, or to get on like you, you've got to be prepared to travel wherever the job takes. It could be all over the country anywhere.
This isn't your ordinary bread and butter league game tonight, you know. It's a cup tie. Listen, if Everton have won, she'll be in the pub celebrating. If they've lost, she'll be in the same pub crying into a gin and tonic. So stop worrying about her and concentrate on me.
All right, Jeff.
Why am I alone tonight when I should be stepping out?
Tonight, tonight, it all began tonight.
Present the award, a friend and one of the many stars of his shows, please welcome Martin Shaw.
I first became aware of Bill in about 1969 when I was in a play at the Royal Court. And the other actors kept coming backstage and telling me that he was prowling around outside the theatre saying, "That's my part." Remember that? And from this has grown a friendship and a partnership that has challenged and matured me as an actor and provided me with the sort of friend few people have in a lifetime. And when you're a friend of Bill's, you're one of a family that includes Mum, Dad, aunties, Auntie Betty, Lucy, his lovely daughter. And I even get to snog his lovely partner, Jenny Seagrove, every week in our show, Judge John Dee. That is real friendship, believe me. It never fails to amaze me that a man with such a generous and big heart could be so successful in the cut and thrust of show business, but Bill somehow manages it. And my own personal debt to him is enormous. I've lost count of the number of productions we've done together. The two of them, Elvis in Are You Lonesome Tonight and Lord Goring in Ideal Husband, I refused to do consistently. But Bill worked on me and gave me two of the biggest successes I've ever had. When we were on Broadway with Ideal Husband, it was Bill who called me to say that I'd been nominated for the Tony, and that's something you don't forget. Now, for most people, all this would be enough, but he's got a weekend job as well. As deputy chairman of his beloved Everton Football Club, which, like the British Theatre, has seen a change in fortune since his hand has grasped the tiller. The title of this award could have been written for him, so please be upstanding for the winner of the Bernard Delfont Award for an outstanding contribution to show business, Bill Kenwright, CBE.
Well, what can you say? He's probably the West End's greatest impresario. He always prefers to be referred to as producer, director, and entrepreneur. He always relies on his gut instinct when deciding on a production, but often uses his own money so as not to risk an investor's capital. A standing ovation here for Bill Kenwright.
I think in the 51 years you've been presenting this award, you've never had a more thrilled and honoured recipient. When I got the phone call, I was just so overwhelmed. Principally because producers don't get awards, and secondly because, most importantly, the man whose name is on this award, Bernard Delfont, is an extraordinary testament to the variety of thought that makes this business great. It's such a privilege to work with people like Barbara Orbison, Anthony Scher, him back there. I always wanted to be Martin Shaw, and when I grow up, I really will be Martin Shaw, I promise you. And to have this, I'm Wayne Rooney. Is something that words cannot, I promise you, say. It's no big surprise to those who know me that the 10 most successful years of my career have been the 10 most successful years of my personal life. And an awful lot of this very big heart belongs to Jenny. And this is the first major award I've ever received, and I never want to receive another one. I promise you, this is it for me. But my mum, I know, will share this tonight with someone who 25 years ago took me under his wing. Why, I don't know, but he saw something in me at a bad time in my life that probably I didn't even see in myself. And he helped me, he nurtured me, he phoned me every day of my life. And he got me through good times and bad times. Next Monday night, we will open Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat at the New London Theatre. And right in the middle of the stalls, there'll be an empty seat. It's for a man called David Land, who was everything to me, and I miss him every day, for the Variety Club, for the wonderful things that you do, and for making me incredibly happy. I'm so very, very honoured and grateful. Thank you.